Hello, folks. Everybody hear me?
Yeah.
All right. Welcome to the Texas Heritage Songwriters Association Shootout, sponsored by Texas Disposal. This beautiful facility they provided. Hope y'all here to have a great time. We've got an excellent quartet for you. You're all going to have a really good time out there. The most important thing for everybody to remember is safety.
We got the father, Lynn Lenderman, right there.
Okay.
Coming out to shoot. And we've got his son, John Dent.
Okay, here's Brett and his partner getting the lowdown on how to shoot.
Throughout mankind's history, there have been numerous and varied examples of great acts of defiance in the face of overwhelming odds. Arguably, the greatest of these was written by the 26-year-old commander of a 200-odd man garrison in Central Texas in the mid-19th century. The young commander wrote, "Send this to San Felipe by express, night and day. Commandancy of the Alamo, bearer. February 24th, 1836. For the people of Texas and all Americans in the world, fellow citizens and compatriots, I am besieged by 1,000 or more of the Mexicans under Santana. I have sustained a continual bombardment and cannonade for 24 hours and have not lost a man. The enemy has demanded a surrender at discretion. Otherwise, the garrison are to be put to the sword if the fort is taken. I have answered the demand with a cannon shot, and our flag still waves proudly from the walls. I shall never surrender or retreat. And I call on you in the name of liberty, of patriotism, and everything dear to the American character to come to our aid with all dispatch. The enemy is receiving reinforcements daily and will no doubt increase to 3,000 or 4,000 in 4 or 5 days. If this call is neglected, I am determined to sustain myself as long as possible and die like a soldier who never forgets what is due his own honor and that of his country. Victory or death, William Barrett Travis, Lieutenant Colonel, Commandant. P.S. The Lord is on our side. The defenders of the Alamo included Native Tejanos, men from 22 of the 24 United States and 6 foreign countries. With their lives and by their example, these men laid the foundation of our great state, and it is their legacy to us that must be honored. This legacy means that each and every one of us, no matter where we came from or how long we've been here, no matter our skin color, religion, or political affiliation, are part and parcel of a unique wonderful place. Together we are Texas, and may God bless our great state and the men and women who made her so." Thank you.
Close your ears, Jude.
Colorado!
Sir!
The battery will fire one blank round in honor of the great state of Texas. On your command!
Sir!
Yeah.